Previously on Golf! I was on my way to Portugal when I started seeing some creation. Why am I seeing so much sad stuff out the window?
You've been drinking Ronaldo's tears!
Ronaldo's tears?
You're on CR7 Airlines!
I'm on what?
CR7 Airlines!
Pardew, I'm coming! Ronaldo, let me go, bro!
So my girlfriend or mom got me these underwears, boys. What do you think? Should I wear them in a video?
Welcome to the last video of 2016, boys. And basically, just wanted to say a couple things before the video starts. This is the last of the pre-recorded videos that I made in Miami before my Portugal trip. And basically just wanted to say thank you. I just wanted to say thank you for possibly, quite possibly, if not last year, definitely this year, easily the best year of my life. I mean, you guys have made it possible for me to live out my dream job, which is playing FIFA, editing FIFA videos, and essentially entertaining 840,000 people every freaking day. And honestly, from the bottom of my heart, I just wanna say thank you so much. You guys, and I say it every few videos, that you guys enabled me to do the best job in the entire world. 3 years ago, didn't think in my wildest dreams that I was gonna be doing this as a job. For the first year, literally was not able to do it as a job, had a job that I hated. I would come home every day and then make videos that I really, really enjoyed and thought to myself, maybe one day I'll be able to do as a job. And now, I can do it, and you guys have completely changed my life. So as the last video that you guys see in 2016, hopefully this goes live tonight. If not, you might see it tomorrow on the 1st of 2017. Just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. You guys have enabled me to do my dream job. And if you guys are going out tonight, please drink safe, be responsible. I'm gonna be going out in this lovely town that you guys see in the background here, Lisbon, with my girlfriend and her family. So that is gonna be really fun. Not exactly sure where we're gonna go, but really looking forward to that. So, from the bottom of my heart, like I said before, thank you guys so much for allowing me to do this. Thank you for taking this journey with me and hoping that 2017 is as awesome as 2016 was. So hopefully you guys enjoy the video. Let's freaking go. What's up, big boys, and welcome to the youngest team in FIFA Mud Draft Challenge episode. Happy I'm not 100% sure what day this is, bros. I'm currently in Portugal. If you're watching this, this is one of my pre-recorded videos, but this is one of those episodes that I'm really freaking excited to do. The last time we did an age-based foot draft, we did the oldest foot draft, went out in the third round, and I thought to myself, you know what? Because we're probably gonna have a team full of old players, we're not gonna win the entire thing because there is a direct correlation between age and pace. Let me bring you over to my chart that I worked on for 2 days. The younger you are in FIFA, the better probability that you have a little bit better pace than someone that's older. Then you reach a point in your life where your pace is described in one word. Basically, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through the entire foot draft. And when every selection pops up, we are gonna go with the youngest player, regardless of chemistry, regardless of rating. We are just gonna go and base our selection off the youngest player in each selection. At the time of recording this, I haven't lost 2 foot drafts, even though we had some pretty crazy stipulations. So I'm on a 2 foot draft winning streak. If we could make it 3, I think that would be the first time we've ever done it on the channel. That is exactly what we're gonna try and accomplish. If you guys do enjoy the episode, smash that like button. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. And per usual, every time I do a foot draft epi, I like to hear from you guys where there's a stipulation or something cool that I could do, something fresh, because that's what I'm looking for. I'm always looking for a way to make something a little bit more interesting. You know, I don't wanna do the oldest foot draft again. I don't wanna do the youngest foot draft again. Love doing spicy new, spicy. Holy shit, spicy. All right, boys, here we go. We're about to pop into the foot draft. 15,000 coins. Can we get ourselves a sweet formation? 4-2-3-1 wide. The 4-4-2 flat is one that I really, really enjoy. 4-4-2 holding, 4-3-1-2. And I think the one we've had the most success with. The most success with. Rodriguez Umtiti. Ooh, Davo Sukor. The Croatian hyperlink right there. James is probably going to be the youngest. Umtiti really the player we're going to have to... We're really going to have to take Umtiti over Sukor and Rodriguez. I mean, I guess at least we get a good start with our center back, but holy shit, that is not the start that you want with the youngest foot draft. We get Falcao, who has himself an inform card. Drogba, obviously, 78, 86, and 92. It looks like they may ended up, they actually may end up feeding us Liga BBVA. Hit us with a Barca player first, Morata, second, Cuadrado, Shaqiri's 91, Mahrez is 91. So between Shaqiri and Mahrez, I think we're gonna go Shaqiri just because Mahrez does have himself a frozen team of the group stage card that we could get. Midfielder, God, no informs. I haven't seen one inform yet. Jack Wilshere, 92. I think we go Wilshere there. Well, have to go Wilshere there because he's the youngest. Boys, this stipulation is absolutely insane. Gerrard,
He's not winning any youngster points. Duran 87, Parejo 89, and then Mrs. Kitzel 89 as well. Wait, so it's between Parejo and Mrs. Kitzel, and I think the choice here is easy. We do go Parejo. What do you want? Yeah, that, I think, whatever, we'll figure it out down the road. But youngest foot draft, and they are not being kind to us whatsoever. 90, 93, looks like Ferreira Carrasco is going to be our midfielder. So we can do that. That gets us up to 36. No, that's actually us. We're better. Can you hit us with like an inform or something? Giroud, Costa, Adjeriz, and Vardy. Vardy, I think, was born in 87. Benteke's 90. Yeah, Vardy's 87. Benteke is 90, so we have to go Benteke. Not a bad little... Benteke on 7 chem doesn't look bad, even though we would prefer his inform card. Most of our players are on 7 chem currently, so it could be a whole lot worse. We've got Mendy, Torres, Santos. Yo, what are these selections? All right, so between Santos and Mendy. I think we'll just go Mendy because it'll be easier to link. Second center back, can you hit us? Dude, like literally, I don't think I've seen an inform yet. I genuinely don't think that I've seen an inform yet. Okay, so Matip or Van Dijk. I think we'll go Matip, better overall card. So we'll go Matip there. Gets the link with Wilshire, as would Van Dijk have. Our right back Roberto, one front Janmaat and Coleman. Roberto's 92, and that's perfect. Roberto's 92. And I think that is exactly what we're looking for. Gets the hyperlink there. So we're up to 70 chemistry already. 81 rating, 71 chemistry. Hopefully we get hit with some freaking... Dude, where are the inform cards? Ruffier, I think, is probably going to be the youngest. So it's between Lloris and Ruffier. French, and it links up perfectly. But obviously, want to go Lloris. 88 overall. 83 rating, 80 chemistry, without even having any of our reserves or subs filled out yet as options. Absolutely incredible. All right, Depay. I'm thinking probably Depay is going to be the youngest here. He's 94. Yeah, Depay's gonna be 94, and he could slot in quite nicely there, so up to 79, even though we go down one chemistry. I'm not sure why, I guess it's because of that position. Tanay and Larondo, they hit us with the same guy yet again. 94. Tanay, my god, boys. This is probably, in terms of chemistry, like, we're looking pretty good, but in terms of actual cards that we're getting, these have been some of the more shit that I've ever seen. Gaetan, Courtois, Perisic, Ruffier, Trax, who's the youngest. 92. Dude, Courtois born in 92? Holy shit, I didn't realize that. Not going to be able to fit him in. Obviously, we want Lloris in there. Lopez, 90, Felipe Luis, Vardy. I'm thinking 90, 87. All right, so Lopez, damn. They're handing us keepers left, right, and center. How many keepers do we have? Do we have 3 keepers right now? What a freaking waste, boys. And Yama, another keeper in a selection. 92, 87, and it is going to be Quincy from... We don't have one inform. We have not one inform in our subs, in our starting 11, or our reserves. 89, Ruma's 94. Wow. I think my foot draft might be glitched. Mago, finally we get one, but we're not... Freaking hell, dude, isn't Bebe like... unusually young, dude. He's only 26, but he looks like he's freaking 40. Mahrez is what? 91? Hold on. Mahrez might be the youngest. Please, Deliofu, don't. 94, you son of a bitch! Dude! Deliofu, you just ruined it! We could have had Mahrez! Shit! And I was kidding. Obviously, we have ourselves Depay. He's one of our informs, and then our right back is our other inform. But I've never had done a foot draft where I've received less informs than the ones I am right now. By the way, Oscar, going to China for 20 million. He's going on a 350,000 pound a week wage. What is that? And funnily enough, we actually have to select him because he is the youngest player. So the question is going to be either Oscar, who's the other midfielder that we got? Clichy. I know Clichy's a little up there. Clichy's 85. He's 31. Murillo or Moreno. And yeah, dude. Choice is easy here. We're gonna go Moreno, slot him in. We're up to 91 chemistry, boys. This is the bet, dude. We're gonna possibly have 100 chemistry despite having selected the youngest players in the selections as our stipulation. We might be on 100 chemistry. We've got Sako. Holy shit. But we're probably not gonna want to replace Umtiti because he's already on 10. So that's fine. We've got Matip, Look at, dude, this is actually beautiful. We're gonna have four keepers as well. EA, you're not giving us any informs and you're loading us up with keepers. And this is the squad, boys. This is the youngest foot draft I have ever done. Oh, man. All right, so this guy helps out four of our links. We obviously don't have any Bundesliga players. We have a couple of French players, but they're already on enough chem. This guy helps out four, and then this guy helps out five. I think we're going to want to go Juandre Ramos. We are up to 183. We've got 100 chemistry, boys. The likes of Depay, Coutinho, Courtois have no special cards whatsoever. We missed out on Neymar. He's one of the younger players, one of the younger, higher-rated players in FIFA. Didn't get him. We do have ourselves Depay. We've got Benteke. We've got Morata. The youngest foot draft episode. Can we go all the way? Stefan Effenberg, inform Sanchez, inform Aguero, Eriksen. He's got inform 89 Pogba and Kyle Walker. Now it's not like the stipulation prevented us from getting any of those players. We just weren't given any. Take a sip of my creme brulee iced coffee because I'm gonna need some help. Morata! Come on, boys, let's go. Patience, patience, patience. We were knocking on the door a couple times. Nice little body paint. First time I've... Crazy that I'm actually saying this right now, but the first time I've seen a really, really successful body paint in FIFA 17 inside the box. I haven't had a lot of success with it.
Oh my God. One-on-one with Alexis Sanchez. Wow. He got nervous.
He couldn't take me on one-on-one. Very even match. The only difference, that Morata body paint, that Morata finish. Let's get in the second half. Let's freaking continue. Let's freaking continue. Like, what's the other option? Not continuing? Stopping the video right here? Oh, here we go. 2-0. Morata doesn't miss that moment! Let's freaking go! Is he that disheartened that he's gonna rage when we start over? It's only round number one, so he might as well just be bringing on a couple subbies. And that's a pen. Can we get Morata the hat trick? We are getting Morata the hat-trick, my dudes!
Don't worry about it. Don't you worry.
Match number one, the youngest squad came up against a really, really tough opponent, had frigging inform striker Sanchez, inform Aguero up top, and then Effenberg, who we ended up bringing off for Royce. Have been seeing a lot of that lately. I think a lot of streamers are doing that as well, so people are taking notes. 7 shots, 6 on target, 54% possession. We win match number one. Match number two, Los Gates. Is this National Effenberg Day? What the actual Effenberg, bro? Okay. Alright, that was just an absolute shit joke.
Are we actually matched up against the German guy wearing the Brazilian? That is a fucking shot if I've ever seen one.
Woohoo! Coutinho! Coutinho the Nino! Let's freaking go, boys! Little bit of a wiggle, and then the blast. That's just that angle, boys. That is the FIFA 17 angle, worked in 16 as well. Holy freaking shit.
Benteke.
Doesn't have lead speed. See an opening there. Lay it off. Morata 2-0, and there's the rage quit. Boys, the youngest foot draft ever. You wouldn't expect an inexperienced side. He rides quick, cut. No goals conceded. Match number three, usually the toughest one we come up against, but I'm feeling really confident in the way the squad's playing. Like, I don't feel like Lloris is being tested at all. He had, like, one shot taken on. Finally, a guy who actually doesn't have Effenberg. 185 squad rating versus my youngest 183. Match number three. Vamos!
Line up today. Juan Fran starts with Marcelo as the fullbacks. Casemiro starts with Thiago in the middle. Cristiano Ronaldo. Yeah. Playing through him. Hoping to work. Nicolas Benteke.
Dude, that's actually sick listening to the commentary. Wow. Bro, 0 shots on target. Why do I feel... Dude, I feel like I'm outplaying this guy.
Go in the second half. Focus attack very well. In his position there.
Depay!
Oh! They got into the lead.
Let's go!
Second best for much of this game up to now. Lead. piece of finishing. That's the goal.
That was a five piece of finishing. Thank you, Martin Tyler.
Head down the wing, keeping the wide attack going.
Oof. Let's go, Teke! Guys, we have six goals in three matches. We haven't conceded a goal yet. Beautiful freaking finish from Benteke. There it is, boys, the big man Benteke dance. Now, he's a guy that I would possibly want to take through Weekend League.
Clean
sheet!
God damn it, dude.
Well, that was filmed extra special for this goalkeeper because he did late in the match.
That doesn't deserve to be counted as a goal, bros. That was a shit. That was a glitch goal, dude. I cleared it. I guess I shouldn't have cleared it in traffic, but... And there you have it, boys. Match number three. It was my fault to clear it in traffic. I shouldn't have cleared it in traffic. So we didn't keep the clean sheet. I will take that as my fault. Shouldn't have cleared it in traffic. More importantly, though, and unfortunately for this guy, he had 10 shots on target, one goal. I had 4 shots on target, 3 goals. It comes down to efficiency in this game. Speaking of efficiency, we are just absolutely tearing it up. Let's get to the final. See if we can get ourselves... For the first time ever, like a good draft reward if we win. That's not even guaranteed. We're in the final, boys, and we're coming up against a beastly-looking squad. Glitch Signe. Freaking Torre. He's got a couple screamer cards at center back. So winning this foot draft right here would mean I won 3 foot drafts in a row. Have never done that on the channel. TT just got freaking beat. Boys, we have plenty of time. If there's one thing we have going for us, it's only 23rd minute. How do I have 0 shots on target again? Are my shots on target not registering? I feel like I have shots on target. What do I have to do? How did that go in? How did that actually go in? I'm not gonna complain though, I feel like I deserve that. That goal was coming a long time. Off his ass, the ass goal. Courtois just... Dude, Courtois like scared of the ball. Wait, what? The subs didn't come on? Oscar? Wilshire? We'll take off Depay. Bring on Shaqiri. And those will be our subs. Come on, extra time. Who can be the hero? Yes!
Oh my god, no.
Oh! Shaqiri monster! Whoa! 110th minute! I'm not gonna watch the replay because I'm classy.
Oh my god, are you kidding me?
Let's go, the $20 million man cleans it up! We're gonna win ourselves our 3rd consecutive foot draft, boys! We win the foot draft! 3 times in a row! The triple win, all with different sort of stipulations. Strongest foot draft, oldest foot draft, we didn't win it, but we do get it with the most youthful foot draft ever. 12 shots, 7 on target for me, 11 shots, 5 on target for him. But the thing that I'm looking forward to, and I'm gonna have to mute this because it's gonna be really, really loud if I don't mute it, is what sort of draft reward are we going to get? Look at that, 2-0, 2-0, 3-1, 3-1. Can we get coins? Premium gold player, and a mega pack! I think that's a 50K pack. All right, boys, so we got our premium gold player pack. We have our mega pack. We're gonna blast open our premium gold player pack. I think this is probably our best draft reward to date. And in terms of payout, easily not our best ever. Bonaventura, 82 overall. but I think it's that mega pack that we're looking forward to. Hermachi Utaka, beast player in, I believe, K-League? Come on, dude! EA, give me something! Galvin Lair! It worked! And it's not a great one! 81 overall, Roger! But we get ourselves an Inform in a reward pack! I think the first time, outside of getting a shit November card, we get ourselves an Inform. Is there anyone else hiding in there? Roger. And did we get any other players towards the end of it? Diarra, Albiol, Mauricio. Three drafts that we've won in a row. Still haven't gotten the coin prize, which I would love to get. That would be sick to get that 30,000 or 45,000 or whatever it is. I think there's varying levels of it. But pretty happy with that pack. We got ourselves an Inform. We can't complain. But anyway, boys, that is the youngest foot draft episode. We won it three times in a row. Hopefully you guys did enjoy the episode. If you did, smash that like button. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Hopefully you guys have a great rest of the day, and I will see you guys for another upload tomorrow. Till next time, tschüss, later, ade.